Good morning. Today, the judgment, doctrinal judgment, doctrinal. It deals with the virus of Section 45 of the Money Laundering Act, wherein similar provisions that of 36. A of NDPS Act and other Special Provisions Act has been incorporated, that while considering bail, prima facie should be considered by giving notice to public person. While deciding that the judges have dealt with Magna Carta, the history of bail, the history of habeas corpus, what not. So those who are pursuing postgraduate law courses, doctorate in law, and used to write article, project report, must go through the judgment, keep the judgment on your table always. You can cut and paste and understand several areas, and you can incorporate those in some other project report, like human rights. So many international conventions were discussed. A fantastic judgment. I want to share with you. Okay, I will go through the judgment now. The judgment was AIR 2017 Supreme Court 5500 Nikesh Tarachandra versus Union of India. The Section 45 was 44 of Prevention of Money Laundering Bill 1999, which referred only to offences punishable under this Act itself, in which twin conditions for grant of bail were imposed in addition to limitation for such grant under Code of Criminal Procedure. Some of these provisions did not translate into dealing with offences under 2002 Act, but became 45 of the 2002 Act, which was brought into force in 2005. Change made by Section 45 is that the purpose of grant, what was now to be looked at, was offences that were punishable for term imprisonment of 3 years or more under Part A of the schedule, and not offence under Section 202 Act itself. At this stage, this A contains two schedules. All these things have to you go through. Then they say, they say statutory scheme as originally enacted was Section 45 in present avatar would therefore lead to same offenders in different cases having different results. Bail depending on whether Section 45 does or does not apply. Twin condition laid down under Section 45 would have no nexus whatsoever with bail petition, which concern itself with offence of money laundering, or if Section 45 is to apply. Then they say the Section 45 is a drastic provision which stands on its head, presumption of innocence, which is fundamental to person accused of any offence. This is most important. Before application of section which makes drastic inroads into fundamental right of personal liberty guaranteed under Section 21 of the Constitution, court must be doubly sure that such provisions further compelling state interest for tackling serious crime. Absence of any such compelling state interest, indiscriminate application of Section 45 will certainly violate Article 41. So this Section 45 was declared as ultra vires. So for this, you go through all those things. I would invite your attention for this 2002 Money Laundering Act, then United Nations Convention Against Illicit Traffic, Basel Settlement of Principles, then Financial Action Task Force, which was established, Political Declaration, the Global Program of Action adopted by United Nations General Assembly, United Nations Special Sense on Countering World War Drug Problem Together concluded. Then the history of bill was discussed. You see, section, what all are the, if you want to understand the Money Laundering Act, you can go through this paragraph, which describe elaborately the each section. Then, I want you to understand and go through this paragraph 10, history of bail. The provision for bail goes back to Magna Carta. Written in Latin, class 39, no free man shall be seized or imprisoned or stripped of his rights or possessions or outlawed or exiled or deprived of his standing in any other way, nor will he proceed to with force against him or send others to do so except by lawful judgment of his equals or by the law of land. See wordings of this Magna Carta. The history of Magna Carta, John, King John, 12,015, then all other histories, then they say, then they have said, England has Partition of Rights Act 1628 was enacted, then again another act was enacted, Habeas Corpus Act of 1679 was enacted. All must, you should go through this, what is Article 1, Section 9 of the U.S. Constitution was referred. Multiple judgments were also discussed, including foreign judgment. Then American jurisprudence, it was stated, where the granting of bail lies within the discretion of the court, the granting or denial or regulated logic by the facts and circumstances of each particular case. So, judgment of the court, the primary inquiry is whether a recognizance or bond would affect that end. So, bail is sufficient. That was they say. Then, you see, the Manaka Gandhi, the locomotive right, was discussed, say, at various pages. Manaka Gandhi case, they say. Then they say, our constitution has no due process clause or the English 8th Amendment, but in breach of law after Cooper and Manaka Gandhi, the constitution, so due process of law, the title of due process of law is been discussed for volume of books. Due process of law is such a huge term for rights, human rights, international human rights. Then A.K. Gopalan case also discussed. Then they have discussed about various other provisions, various acts which deals with this sort of prohibition for prohibition, restriction for grant of bail, Arms Act, Wildlife Protection Act, Immoral Traffic Act, Prevention of Corruption Act. Then you see, Explosive Act, Antiquities and Treasures Act, Exchange Board of India Act, Customs Act, so many acts were discussed. That is also you should be. Then they have discussed about this they say Section 45 would directly violate Article 14 and 21 in as much as procedure for bail would become harsh, burdensome, wrongful and discriminatory depending upon whether a person is being tried for an offense, which also happens to be happens under Part A of the schedule. So this only to that extent this provisions was scrapped. So then they say finally they very then Kartar Singh case was discussed. Everybody knows about Kartar Singh case. Then United States was Anthony Salerno and Vincent Cafaro, 481 U.S. 739 judgment. Provision of the Bail Reform Act 1985 allowed a federal court to permit pre-trial detention on the ground that the person arrested is likely to commit future crimes. See, there they have got some improvement. So these all are most important. Then finally they say, thus, this 45 Act has not legally sustainable, and therefore all the bail application is directed to be rediscussed and disposed. Best wishes.